Nutrients are crucial for all living things and the cells they're made of. The amount of nutrients around tell your cells if it's a good time to grow or not, and their ability to tell this difference is very important for our health. Unfortunately, this ability seems to change with age, and not in a good way. One of the hallmarks of aging is a shift in how our cells measure the amount of nutrients available to them. If we could understand how nutrient sensing mechanisms relate to aging, it might be possible to tweak them to help people live longer or at least stay healthy for longer. Each of your cells is basically a tiny factory full of molecular machines. There are engines to produce power, motors to move things about, machines to build things, and lots more. Like any factory, a cell relies on fuel and raw materials to do its work. Cells get those from the nutrients in the food we eat. But cells need to know how many nutrients are available so they know how hard to work. Molecular networks that sense nutrient levels act as accelerators and brakes for cellular machinery, but their activity also has consequences for aging. One of the best examples is probably the insulin-related IIS pathway, which is activated by plentiful nutrients and ramps up growth and metabolism in response. Researchers found that mice, worms, and flies with a weakened IIS pathway all live longer. But low IIS levels are also seen in prematurely aged mice. Somehow, reduced IIS is linked with both longevity and premature aging, so what's going on? A model proposed in 2008 suggests that low IIS levels help protect cells by reducing growth and metabolism. It's a bit like running an engine at a lower speed to keep it from overheating. Cells with less active cellular machinery accumulate less damage. That means that mice with low IIS levels throughout their lives live longer, while older mice turn down their IIS response in an attempt to extend their lives. Another molecular pathway, known as mTOR, also detects high nutrient levels and revs up cellular metabolism in response. In experiments, yeast, mice, worms, and flies with a mutated or deleted version of the mTOR gene lived longer. Scientists could also extend lifespan by blocking mTOR activity with a drug called rapamycin. When researchers fed mice rapamycin along with their food, the mice lived 5 to 15% longer, and this is especially exciting because the experiment was done in older mice, roughly equivalent to a 60-year-old person, so it's not an intervention that would only help young people. But mTOR is important in a lot of processes, which means that inhibiting it can have lots of side effects, including impaired wound healing, insulin resistance, cataracts, and more. So while it's an extremely promising tool, it's not quite a miracle drug. While the mTOR and IIS pathways both detect high nutrient levels, two other pathways, AMPK and SIRT, are used to sense low nutrient levels. Unsurprisingly, their effect on aging is also opposite of IIS and mTOR. In different model species, higher levels of AMPK or SIRT signaling have been shown to extend lifespan along with healthspan, which is how long an animal stays healthy. There are also connections between the different pathways. There is evidence that AMPK shuts off one of the mTOR molecular complexes, that SIRT affects the IIS pathway, and that AMPK and one of the SIRT genes reinforce each other's signaling. These interconnections and the fact that the pathways affect so many processes make it harder for researchers to tease apart their exact links with aging or figure out what interventions could be most helpful. The overall picture that is emerging is that cells monitor nutrient availability so they can regulate their activity to balance growth and the stress and damage that it causes. Tweaking this mechanism can shift the balance, but it has to be done carefully and with proper understanding, and we're just not there yet. But even if we don't yet know how everything works, there is one intervention that we know definitely helps. Caloric restriction, that is, consuming fewer nutrients without becoming malnourished, is known to increase lifespan in lots of species. We don't know whether it makes humans live longer, but we know that it reduces a lot of indicators and risk factors associated with diseases. Caloric restriction is probably linked with nutrient signaling. It seems to act partly through the mTOR and SIRT pathways, but it's a topic we'll explore more thoroughly in an episode of its own. Thank you very much for watching this episode of Extend, and thanks for commenting, liking, and sharing with your friends. If you are new around here and liked this episode, I invite you to subscribe by clicking the red subscribe button on youtube.com/lifespan.io. If you'd like to help us produce more episodes like this one, you can do so by joining the Lifespan Heroes, our generous supporters, at lifespan.io/hero. Your pledge will help us keep our show going, as well as our blog, conferences, and crowdfunding campaigns. By the way, X10 will soon move to its own dedicated YouTube channel. We expect to officially launch it at some point in early September, but if you like, you can already subscribe to it. Head over to this address and click subscribe.